preacher said testify. I was kind of had it on my mind too anyway. But just like I say, thank the Lord for His saving grace, for His mercy. You know, just the Lord has been, He's been mighty good to us. He's been good to a lot of us. We can never thank Him for all His goodness and His mercy and His grace. And like I say, I guess sometimes with myself, we take all this great facility and all of these the things we have for granted sometimes, and that it's always going to be here. You know, God has blessed this church and blessed us with a lot of fine people. And like I say, I just count it a privilege and an honor to be able to come to the Bible Church of God. And there's a lot of good churches out there, but I just thank the Lord He put me here and He saved me and changed my life close to 40 years ago. I never thought I'd be doing a lot of things I'm doing. I was living for the devil. Just thought that was, I'll serve God later. I'll catch you later, God. But the good Lord got a hold of my heart and changed me, give me a good wife. I'll put that in verse. And He's blessed me in so many ways. We've had our trials and our tribulations. We all have. And God said we would. Until we endure to the end. And that end may be sooner than we think. You know, I don't live in fear. I don't go to sleep. I used to go to bed in fear because I feared it. I knew I was lost in the none. But I can lay my head down now at night knowing that me and the good Lord, everything's right. And I've treated people as fair as I could treat them between men. I don't have to dread that. But I just like to say I love the Lord and love all the fine folks of Donald Church of God. Keep on working and praying, and one day, like I say, till we meet up there again. The worship of the night, I can't even walk, and I can't without the Lord holding my hand. Thought I would be what
Peace. he had to say, it was good. It was really good. And I noticed he didn't have anything wrote down when he said it. He must be in trouble with Tina to say something like that about her. I just don't have no time to cancel right now. I'm sort of busy. But I hope it works out between you. How many love the Lord here tonight? Amen. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and tell them you love them and you're glad to see them in the house of the Lord. Won't you stand up? Just stand up if you will. I don't have any musicians here. But just turn around and shake all those hands around you. Tell those folks how glad you are to see them. Praise the Lord. Preach to soothe people's hearts. I want to preach what God gave me. And sometimes it's not easy to tell the truth. And a lot of pastors don't want to do that today. But when I stand before you and stand behind this pulpit, I've got to give account for everything that I preach. And I've got to preach, Brother Ronnie, what the Lord did. It's good to see Ronnie and his son back tonight. Leonard was sick this morning. We prayed for him, and you see him back in the house of God tonight. I'm thankful for that. You got your Bible? I want to preach tonight on the journey of joy. The journey of joy. It's almost like the moon and the sun, what I will preach tonight from this morning. John chapter 15 and 10-11 said, if you keep my commandments, you shall abide in my love. Even if I have kept my Father's commandments and abided in his love, these things I have spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you and that your joy may be full. Amen. So good to have Brother Alfred back with us tonight. Brother Alfred, would you pray God's blessing on this message? The journey of joy, the road to happiness. Construction on the highway, we've all seen it more than our share of highway construction, where you have to sit and wait. Lots of heavy equipment and earth movers and removing of old pavements, and it causes long delays at time, and traffic gets backed up and it becomes a headache for those that are trapped. A bright idea is one construction era in Ohio, there was an unusual amount of tension. The motors were becoming hostile. In other words, they had road rage. And the workers were frustrated. I can imagine how they feel when we come by honking the horn or knocking one of those barriers down. But they were real frustrated. So to resolve the tension, one worker resorted to some good humor. And he purchased bumper stickers for all the heavy equipment. They all said it the same thing. The road to happiness is almost always under construction. Amen. I want you to think about that a little bit. Humor or human happiness. The pursuit of happiness. The Bill of Rights states that we have the right to pursue happiness. Ways that we search for happiness is up to us. Sometimes we make mistakes. Our society has always searched for new ways to gain happiness. If you want to know how to do it, tune in to Dr. Phil. He can tell you. In fact, he can tell you anything that you need to know. But I don't know that it worked for me. We think that happiness comes from situation or things. Some people say, I'd be happy if I had more money. Do you really think you would? I don't. I know you may say tonight, Sister Mary, I'd like to try. Judy's raising her hand. If I had the right kind of job, somebody that really cared about me, I'd be happy. We may have the right to pursue happiness, but that does not mean that you're going to find it. There's a secret in happiness. And I'm not talking about a long-term marriage either. I'm talking about happiness. Look at Roseanne and Jack. They're happy. At least Roseanne is. But what is happiness? The most pronounced type he wrote said, "I wish I had a man that had everything he wanted when he died." He said, "I wish I had never been born." Certainly not in pleasure. Lord Byron lived in a life of pleasure. If anyone did it, he did it. But he wrote, "The worm, the canker, and the griefs are mine alone." Jay Good, the Merkin millionaire, had plenty of money. When he died, I suppose I am the most miserable man on earth. Not in military glory. Alexander the Great conquered the known world in his day. Having done so, he wept because there were no more worlds to conquer. What's the secret? There is no secret. We have become so busy looking for joy that we have missed it completely. The secret of happiness is finding the true source of joy and where it comes from.
Amen.
Happiness isn't found in things of life, in situations that benefits you. Happiness is a source in the joy that comes from God.
Amen.
If you want to have a happy home, put God right in the middle of it. If you want to have a happy wife, let her get saved. If you want a happy husband, let them know Jesus in the full pardon of their sin. If you want happiness, walk in His precept through His word 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and you'll find out that it's joy unspeakable, and the Bible said it's full of glory.
1 Chronicles 16:23-31
said, "Sing to the Lord, all the earth, proclaim His salvation day after day. Declare His glory among the nations, His marvelous deeds among all people. For great is the Lord and most worthy of His praise. He is to be feared among all gods. For all the gods of all the nations, an idol but the Lord, made the heavens. Splendid and majestic are before Him. Strength and joy in the dwelling place. Ascribe to the Lord, O families of nations. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due His name. Bring an offering and come before Him. Worship the Lord in the splendor of holiness. Tremble before Him on all earth. The world is firmly established to it cannot be moved. Let the heaven rejoice. Let the earth be glad. Let them say among the nation, the Lord reigns." Will you lift your hands and say that with me tonight? The Lord reigns. Do you believe it? Do it one more time. The Lord reigns. Who is He? He is our risen Savior. He's the one that's coming back to get us. My God, it's time for us to understand. We may be on a journey, but it don't have to be a sad journey. It can be a journey of joy that's full of glory. And all you got to do is accept it.
Amen.
You know, I hear a lot of folks saying, "Well, I'm not going to be happy till I get to heaven." Well, if you live to be 100 years old, You're going to be sad the whole 100 years? Brother Milton, I believe you can have a little glory right here on earth.
Amen.
I see glory every day. I see glory in my children. No, they don't always do what I want them to do. Oh, preacher, I thought the preacher's kids would do it. Tommy Rod. My children ain't no different than your children. What your children would do, my children would do it. Brittany's went off to the National Guards in the Army. She did it because one of her friends joined. She wanted to join. You can't always follow the leader.
Amen.
Now she's called home and she said, Papa, and broke our hearts. She said, Papa, I wished I was back home. Listen, you better understand, we're on a journey. I don't know if you realize that or not. We're on a journey, Brother Taylor. This journey consists of many things. There's trouble, there's trial, there's sickness, there's death, there's disappointment. Oh, but the other end of this journey is going to be life evermore. Hallelujah. And you need to understand, your life may to enjoy life. You hear what I said? I see people, God help me, that sits around and they're sad all the time. I don't know, a few years back, I preached on, I don't want to be happy. I want to be sad. And when I was little, milk got me this way. But when I was little, we watched cartoons before we went to school. Brother Sam, y'all probably didn't do that. But at that time, they had a ball. And they would sing little songs. And they'd say, sing the ball as it goes across the world. How many knows what I'm talking about? Oh, yeah. About my age. Right, I know you sing. And they'd sing songs, Brother David. And we'd sit there and sing them as the ball would jump on top of the words. And they'd sing little songs like, I don't want to be happy. I want to be sad. You know, some folks in the world today has got that frame of mind. They think it's a sin if you laugh. Well, I got news for you. If you're around me and I ain't in the pulpit, you're going to laugh because I'm going to make you laugh.
Amen.
I don't feel like that you ought to go through life, Brother Alfred, being saved.
Amen.
There's things in life like Sister Zadie that makes us sad, and we don't like that, and we're praying that God would deliver her, and I believe He has the power, but I'm praying for God's will, and I know that's what most of you doing, but I'm here to tell you, you don't have to wait till you get to heaven to enjoy life. You can have a little bit of heaven right here on earth and enjoy. I enjoy a good life. You know what the Bible talks about? Laughter being good for you. Some of you ought to try it sometime. You'll find out it works. Laughter will make you feel good. It'll make you feel good about yourself. It'll make you do things. I was thinking about Judy when I was getting this message. She's got the worst habit. She calls everybody hun. She knows what I'm fixing to say. Color lady come up at the place where she works and she said,
Anything else for you, hon? Cause the lady looked at her, or black lady, whatever you want to call it, looked at her and said, I'm not your hon. She said, okay, I'm sorry, hon.
Sometimes she just don't get it.
Sister Lawrence told me I like to fill out the car lane. She said, I'm sorry. That's where it went. But she said, I'm sorry. She said, well, I'm not your hon.
I know a lady that does.
Listen, folks.